In celebration and thanksgiving for the 2020 academic year. We begin this morning with our acknowledgement of country and carries on. We are honoured to be gathered to acknowledge country, dance on country, sing on country, visit country. We speak to country, care for country, long for country. We pay our respects to elders past and present and thank them for passing on their knowledge, our language, and spiritual connections to country. Country is lived on and lived with. Country gives and receives life. Our charism, our spiritual history. We acknowledge the Brigidine sisters and their tireless efforts in founding the college and their role in nurturing the faith of the young women at Brigidine. As models of St. Bridget, the sisters have always and will continue to inspire the students of Brigidine College to be young women of strength and gentleness. Welcome to our many parents, grandparents, and guardians who join us via live stream today. I extend a very warm welcome to our Brigidine sisters who also join us virtually today. And importantly, welcome to our staff and students here. I would like to welcome and thank Father Peter for celebrating Mass with us today. While today we acknowledge and celebrate the year that was, we also farewell Father Peter from our Brigidine community. While we celebrate the academic year, we pray today continuing guidance and protection of St. Bridget as we begin our holiday period. May we be guided to act with compassion, courage, hospitality, hope, service, and justice to all we encounter over the coming break and into the 2021 school year. I invite the community to stand for our entrance procession.
on this beautiful day. Good morning to you all.
Good morning, Father.
The kind of sparkle in the air. I wonder why. Let's bless ourselves in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. And may the grace and the peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, our Father, and the friendship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. I really love the double acknowledgement that you have here at the beginning of the Masses. Of the Aboriginal people and the tradition, the life stream coming from them, of this land that they cared for so gently and so beautifully, and of the Brigidine one, which came out of the Gaelic culture, which was very aligned to that, very close to it. It's concern for nature, it's love of beauty, love of nature, of the elements of fire, earth, water, and all the rest of it. So it's a great and a rich tradition which we have here. But I've also the symbols there, the apples, of course, I think the story about one. But the cross of St. Bridget, there's one of the things that she really, really loved, and what I loved too. She, in one of her prayers, she wanted to have a lake of Jesus. I can relate to that, especially a lake of Jesus, something small, big minded. And that's what she's calling us to be too, big, big minded. Not with beer, though. We've been told we drink too much, and so at the end of the year, let's pause for a moment. We're here to give thanks to God, to teachers, to parents, to family, to guardians, to friends, all the rest of them who've helped us through the year. Maybe also there's some shadows there. Let's not leave the year, say we're outside of any teachers or any of the kids in the class, and maybe we know in our heart, I just need to go and say sorry about something, or I need to go and say, yeah, I'm sorry, I didn't forgive you as readily as I might. So that we have a clean book when we leave here tomorrow. Everything's kind of right. We go for a holiday, it's really beautiful and carefree. So we pause for a moment. We acknowledge our need of forgiveness and our need to forgive. Lord, you were sitting here the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. Christ Jesus, you came to call sinners back into life. Christ, have mercy.
Christ,
have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are the human hearts and the human face of God. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. And let us pray. Loving God, we praise you as the source of all we have and are. We thank you for this academic year and for all who have fostered and nurtured us. Teach us to continue to appreciate the many gifts you've given to us and inspire us always. We make this prayer through Christ. Amen. Amen.
Reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. You are God's chosen race, his saints. He loves you, and you should be clothed in sincere compassion, in kindness and humility, gentleness and patience. Bear with one another. The Lord has forgiven you. Now you must do the same. Over all these clothes, to keep them together and complete them, put on love. And may the peace of Christ reign in your hearts, because it is for this that you were called together as a part of one body. Always be thankful. Let the message of Christ in all its righteousness find a home with you. Teach each other and advise each other in all wisdom. With gratitude in your hearts, sing psalms and hymns and inspired songs to God, and never say or do anything except in the name the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, I thank you for your faithfulness and love. Lord, I thank you for your faithfulness and love. I thank you, Lord, with all my heart. You have heard the words of my mouth. Before the angels, I will bless you. I will adore before your holy temple. Lord, I thank you for your faithfulness and love. I thank you for your faithfulness and love. which excel all the avenue of you. On the day I called, you answered. You increased the strength of my soul. Lord, I thank you for your faithfulness and love. Kings shall thank you when they hear the words of your mouth. They shall thank of the Lord's ways. How great is the glory of the Lord. Lord, I thank you for your faithfulness. Hallelujah, hallelujah. The word of the Lord lasts forever. What is the word that is living? It is brought to us through his Son, Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The readings from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "You are the salt of the earth. But if salt loses its flavor, what can we do with it? What will make it salty again? It becomes useless. It can be thrown out to be trod underfoot." And then he said, "You are the light of the world. No one lights a lamp to put it under a bushel basket or under a bed. No, you light the lamp to put it on a lampstand so that it will give light to all who come into its realm. So your lives must be also that way, so that seeing your good works, people may give glory to the Father in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I think when I was in primary school a long time ago, I think there was a bit of an emphasis, because there were nuns teaching perhaps more so than we'd normally find, on being saintly. I used to think being saintly meant to be kind of sickly or something, rather kind of unreal. But then when I was looking at this reading here, I'm hearing it read so beautifully, I thought, yeah, why not all of us strive to be saints? Because what's saint all about? Sincere compassion. Give us another look at our world. Look at our world. Billions of people without care in this COVID period, because there's no one there to organise it for them. So many places where there's a lack of compassion, so many places where there's greed seems to be a thing that brings many countries to their knees, greed, coming out of an exalted sense of pride, and then people suffer. So sincere compassion, not just doing something rather, but from the heart. And then the other virtues of the saint, kindness. We had a little preschool there at Olsch, and kindness is the kind of the motto of the place. Be kind. Well, you can't go pretty wrong with being kind. Humility comes from the word humus, meaning the earth. And I think when we think about the Aboriginal spirituality we talked about in the introduction, and also the Brigidine one, yeah, being connected, to realise that everything is interconnected. And that the fundamental sacrament of the world is our planet Earth. We don't have another one anywhere else. So humility, I think, means knowing our place, where we fit in, and not trying to push the borders and push everything out of whack that distorts things. So humility, it's a difficult thing. Great Saint Teresa of Avila said there are two foundation pillars for the spiritual life. We're all spiritual beings, and they are humility and forgiveness, reconciliation. In a sense, some people are more kind of by their DNA and their personalities more inclined to those sorts of things. Others of us really have to struggle with it for whatever reason. Then gentleness. You know, not barging into people's lives, not coercing them, not pushing them around. But allowing, okay, let's see other possibilities when things get pear-shaped and all the rest of it. You know, you might be surprised to know that many people still come to the sacrament of reconciliation, to confession, as we call it. It's been a little bit dimmed down now because of the COVID thing. We're sitting there with masks on. I don't know what would happen if someone out on the other side of the city, hoping that the microphone to the choir actually turned off and not on. And people, of course, when they come to confession, they're looking at the negatives in their lives. Very often, the will say, okay, for penance, go out, give thanks to God for 4 or 5 truly beautiful things in the door that enters into the house that you're welcomed in, which is healthcare. You've got a beautiful part of the planet being in here. So kind of a gentleness with ourselves, so even with our own faults, except that less, of course, our faults are really disturbing others. We need to do something fairly kind of dramatic there at times. Patience, you would have heard the saying, we taught as kids, patience is a virtue, possess it if you can. Seldom found in woman, and always in a man. Okay, it's my generation, get that one. It's okay, girls, that's fine, it's all right. See, they're a bit more experienced, that's the problem. So we get a bit of away with that. Okay, but patience. It was about, I think, couple stays in hospital this year, and I can see and I can understand, and I'm a hospital chaplain over here. There's a world of difference between someone who visits a hospital and someone in the bed. And I can see why that word came in, you're a patient in the hospital, because patience is a virtue that they really, really, really need. So patience with ourselves and our development and all the rest of it, patience with our learning, patience with the world, patience with God, patience with one another is something. And bear with one another, bearing with one another, especially one another's faults. So very often, if you're a bit of a fiery temperament, I guess we go bang, you know, you want to react straight away. But part of doing it with wisdom, which is part of our education, is taking time, bearing with one another. And the most beautiful thing is, yeah, we live in an environment where we have been forgiven. That's at the heart of the Catholic Christian world, forgiveness. A God whose first name is mercy and forgiveness. That there's nothing at all in this world that cannot be forgiven. Which doesn't mean to say we say, oh, we are, we are, I'll be forgiven, because that's not a responsible way of responding in love. But that's the mystery. When people feel, oh, my life is really, I'm really boxed in here. I don't know where the exits or the entrance are and everything else. No, as a Catholic, we're the people of the resurrection, new beginnings, new life. No matter whether we come off the rails and end up in a total train wreck or whatever it is, not going to happen to you girls, at least not at your age. And remember, it's always. God's first name is mercy and forgiveness. Our Pope is very, very great on that. And then finally, in this little message, you being a saint, and all these things put on love. We have far too much emphasis on physical beauty, I think, far too much emphasis on accomplishments, which in a right perspective, of course, is terribly important to use our talents, but really it's the heart, isn't it? That's the thing. We can have so many things, but not be a person's heart, and that would be a terrible, terrible loss. And I'm really finished. There are two images in the gospel which I really love, and I've been having this gospel at the graduations, salt and light. And if somebody said to you, what do they have in common? You'd probably be scratching your head thinking, salt and light, can't see anything in common. It's a very simple. They don't exist for themselves. They don't exist for themselves. And Bridgetine education is all about that. We are not women for ourselves. We are women for others, people for others, in our family, and in our school, and in life in general. But if we don't want to betray that sense of the heart of Bridgetine education, yeah, we have people for God, for others, to help and to care and to look after one another. Salt brings flavour, preserves, brings out the richness and beauty and taste in things. When we find no taste, that's a bad taste. Let's try and do something about it and bring good taste. Light of the world, without light, no photosynthesis, no life, no nothing really. So light, you might pardon me, that's telling me I should be showing up now. You might think, who am I to talk about light? My light. My light, what have I got to offer? Everyone has something to offer. Now, end on this note. I was visiting the hospital here the other day, and you had to get your temperature taken, you wash your hands and all the stuff when you go in. And a visiting girl came in beside me and said, oh, are you coming to visit someone in your family or someone who's sick? And she said, no, she and her family had maybe a doctor's too strong, or whatever. But we're looking after a woman who became homeless. And she ended up there in an emergency room at in surveillance, and after school, she was going there to visit them. Not so, no big show at all. She was just going there to do that. Didn't think anything of herself, I'm sure. Didn't know to speak. And I thought, well, that to me is a beautiful, beautiful symbol of what we're all called to be, especially what we're called to be as Bridgetine people. Sorry. Let's have our prayers, universal prayers. We'll stand for this one. Lord our God, Father of everlasting goodness, be close to us now and hear the prayers of your faithful people who place their trust in you.
We pray for our entire Bridgetine College community, students, families, and staff. May we be filled with your healing touch and loving spirit over the coming holidays. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
We pray for those who are suffering in our community. May you watch over them and guide them into the path of recovery with your love and strength. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
We pray for those leaving Bridgetine College. May they be welcomed with open arms into their new community and use their experiences from the college to grow and prosper, remembering the Lord will be guiding them in their new journey. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
We pray that we continue to reach out to others in the spirit of welcome and hospitality. May we inspire by the example of St. Bridget and be people of compassion, courage, hope, service, and justice.
Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for Father Peter as he leaves our community. May Christ bless him and reward him for being a faithful servant of God. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray that as we journey into the new year, we reflect on the success of our current academic year and are enriched by our guiding graces as we return into 2021. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, you renew the face of the earth by the power of your Spirit. Hear the prayers we make today through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let's be seated. Bless you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we can have this bread we offer. Fruit of the earth, the work of human hands, it will become our bread of life. Bless to you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine we offer. Fruit of the vine, work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Bless
us. Instead of creating my sacrifice and yours, may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, praise and glory to his name.
Amen. Loving God, we offer this sacrifice of praise for all you have given us. May we always use your many gifts to bring glory to your name through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord, be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father of mercies and faithful God. For you have given us Jesus Christ, your Son, as our Lord and Redeemer. He always showed compassion for children and for the poor, for the sick and for sinners, and he became a leader to the oppressed and the afflicted.
By word and by deed, he announced to the world that you are our Father, and that you care for all your daughters and sons. And so with all the angels and saints, we exalt and bless your name, to sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, those that are in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, those that are in the highest. Let us be seated. You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God. You love the human race. You always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst, when we are gathered by his love. But when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father, most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Spirit to sanctify these gifts, bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and the blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, the Last Supper, he took bread, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his friends, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, he gave you thanks, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory. The mystery of them. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Saviour, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, that whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of offering of your church, in which we show forth the Easter sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us. We grant that, by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in his body and blood we have communion. Bring your church, O Lord, to perfect faith and charity, together with Francis our Pope, Anthony, Terry, Richard, our bishops, and the entire people you have made for them. Open our eyes to the needs of our brothers and sisters. Inspire in us words and actions to comfort those who labor under burden. Make us certain and true after the example of Christ and his command. And may your church stand as a living witness to truth and freedom, to peace and justice, that all people may be raised up to a new hope. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in death in the peace of Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when the earthly pilgrimage is done, and death comes to us, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place, and live happily with you forever. There in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, St. Joseph, her spouse, St. Bridget, Mary McKillop, Jewish family, with all the apostles and martyrs and saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. It should be with him in heaven. O God, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Let's stand up. Pray the prayer of our world wide family, the prayer that Jesus himself taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
You know, of course.
the kingdom, your kingdom come, means God's dream for the world. God's dream reached on a new economy. That's how, that's what God would like to see come about. That's why I say Jesus to us. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. So by the power of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, safe from him with our Saviour, Jesus Christ. The Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, that it may reign forever and ever. May the peace of the Lord be with you. And may God make and may all smile and respond to each other's son and peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. While you're waiting for the Holy Communion to come, what a blessing it is. Just think about the blessings of the meal. What do you want to give thanks to Christ for, to God for? And maybe, what you want to say, yeah, I need a few things to be done by way of forgiveness or whatever it is. Behold the Lamb of God. This is Jesus who accompanies such with love in our journeys through life. Happy are those who are called the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Today, our year 10s received their senior badge, and our year 11 students their year 12 badge. We call upon Father Peter to bless those badges.
Loving God, we have these badges here.
May they guide them to
the guidance of the
lacking in courage, compassion, hope, hospitality, justice and service in their daily lives. May the blessing of the mighty God, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit rest upon these badges and remain with these students forever and ever.
Thank you.
loss, the spine of the flesh to shame. The world sentences of the cross of the others. It's a figure of the lack of the cross of us. The cross is the most cherished and most beautiful and most patient. It represents Christ's suffering and victory. Now it's on Peter to let that.
Be able to see it, but it's got some intricacies of Gaelic tracery around the cross there. And on the part of the incomplete of the cross, the four symbols of the four gospel writers. Earl on the Catholic cross also, which is on the top of that church, cannot be able to hear a problem. That is a circle. There's a cross, there's and a circle, there's an ancient Jewish circle, the four seasons. And the sunrise. So the Christian church took on the cross of Christ being, and the circle became the resurrection of Jesus, the life of everything. So as we look upon the cross, let's call to mind that only Christ has removed all the nations, and out of the many nations created one people of God. When he's now come to eternity and glory, O Father, the Lord Jesus, our King, our priest, and our teacher, free out of the scaffold of the cross, and may it be brought on the throne, his altar of sacrifice, his pulpit of truth. On the cross, he opened out his arms and offered you his life. Father, we honor this cross as a sign of our redemption. May the cross be our comfort in trouble, our refuge in the face of danger, our safeguard of life's journey, to you welcome us to our heavenly home. Grant this through Christ.
And those who have walked the corridors with wisdom, courage, and strength. Wisdom to understand the values we represent and the role of us. Courage to know what is right, and to make choices aligned with the spirit of sacredness. Strength to follow the Christian path with all we do, and through our compassion to bless others. While we may be meaningless, to which deserve retirement, your presence and spirit remains in our hearts within these grounds of Bridgetown. We cannot thank you enough. We cannot thank you sufficiently for what you have given of yourself for the missing years. Nor, I know, do you see acknowledgement for your selflessness. We can carry your spirit and example. So that others may understand the example of God for us and the joy that can be found in seeing Christ in the flesh. May God bless you with the peace and gentle reflection you deserve, and for the gift of your presence within this community that we live for us. Father Peter, you have walked with strength and gentleness, you remain a part of this community. Know that your affection is forever. Extend your right hand towards someone.
as we ask God's righteousness and spiritual. Lord, today we send out our friend, Father, to announce the gospel in new ways. Look upon him with kindness as he leaves this community, marked by your cross, fed by your word, filled with our care, and sent to be your presence to all those with whom he lives. Guide him with your wisdom, that he may be a word of hope for the world. As you give your goodbye to us and continue with your journey, it is our sincere prayer that Christ bless you with wisdom and wonderful life. We thank you for the service you have given to us with so many thanks. May you always have songs of praise in your lips and may you always have Christ in your heart. We ask that you go with God's richest example.
Thank you for sharing that. Thanks, teachers, for good. This one, actually, I'm not going to tire after we do the lesson. I'm actually going on sabbatical with a big plan a long time ago. I was going to go to the Holy Land for service support, that's to Greece, as I said earlier. Back to the university in Belgium, where I've been, to my mother's house in central France, go to a Catholic Spain, and visit a place where we have a martyr. A principal of the school who was stoned to death for standing up against Black magic in South Africa, one of our parishes there. And our community here, a very, very poor, born with a lot of land where he died, and wanted to go back there and see that place. But probably, unless these COVID vaccines have been rushed out, probably not much is going to happen at least until September. Otherwise, I'm on sabbatical until the 1st of October, and I'm looking forward to it. Then I go to our lady's second half parish in Adelaide. But look, if I hate but it's always a privilege to come to a place like this and see girls. I know that there are thousands upon thousands of richly educated girls around the world. It can only be the good of everything, society, the poor, of just the planet, everything in all. Because you give us such a good education, such a great example, and all the rest of it. And to be a good part of that all is a great privilege. So, thank you, and I just pray that all of you know your blessings, and they know that the good spirit of God, with faith, like those early nuns and all the rest of it, you can do wonderful things. Everyone else can do, maybe not great, but in our own way, beautiful and good things. And that's all that we can ask for in our life, and all that God will ask for us too. So, thank you, and God bless you too. Let's stand by the reading. The Lord be with you.
And
may Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Let's go to peace now, Lord, and report of the way we live.
I will rise today through the strength of heaven, light of sun, radiant sun, splendor of fire, speed of lightning, swiftness of wind, death of the sea. Christ with me, Christ for me, Christ.
Good morning, staff, students, parents, and members of the college community that are joining us online for the Year 10 and 11 Presentation Award Ceremony. This heartwarming acknowledgement of student success is always one of the college's most anticipated events. While a global pandemic has altered the format of this year's celebration, we are still excited to recognise the accomplishments of our students. The individuals we celebrate in 2020 have dedicated a significant amount of time and effort in reaching their educational goals. As a result of their hard work, they have excelled in the classroom and on the athletic field. They have made an impact on their communities and they have left their mark on Bridget Dean College. Today, we publicly acknowledge those students who have achieved at an exceptional level academically, as well as those who have shown great determination and resolve in their studies. We also recognise those students who have provided conspicuous service to our college community and to the wider community, local and nationally. But first, I would like to invite Sharon Quirk to the lectern to give her principal's address. Can we make Mrs. Quirk feel welcome, please? Students, staff, and members of our Virginia community, we can finally say we are at the end of a school year. And what a year it has been, overcoming the challenges of COVID, disrupting our teaching arrangements, and some moments of reflection. But we are here. And the fact that we are here is due to the resilience of many to make this happen. My message to you at this time is that 2020 has demonstrated that you never know what it is that it's going to be throwing at you throughout the year. Life is full of uncertainty. And when things happen that surprise you, you need to adjust to deal with it. You need to find meaning in why it happened. And you need to think of others, those around you, and help them cope. Life will not proceed as you wish. We all need to adjust and be prepared to do something differently. We all need to embrace change. We all need to think how we can do things better, do things smarter. Otherwise, we go nowhere. And we remain rooted in one spot. I heard a report last week about how well the Australian economy is going. It's only going well because people have adapted. People have changed. People have collaborated and applied different thought to how they do things. People have shown a willingness to step outside their comfort zones. It is what we must all do, and what you must do as our young women of the future. So, we find ourselves at Christmas. For some, this may be a happy time, for others, sad. Many of us will be separated from our loved ones, but we must be determined to make this work, no matter the challenge. This is the most beautiful time of the year. It is special, and it is only our attitude that will determine how much love and enjoyment we derive from it, how we react and respond to what is before us is within each of us. We just need to unlock it. In considering what I was speaking about today with you, I thought of a Christmas tree. And I'll unpack this little analogy.
Christmas to me is my most favourite time of year. And I thought this Christmas tree analogy was most appropriate, most beautiful, and it is the most spiritual time. Before they departed, I actually asked the U12 students to not be defined by COVID. I said to them that COVID and what has happened this year can be used as an excuse, as a reason for not doing things, or it can be used to move forward with positive energy to feed off which has occurred in a positive way. So I ask the question of each of you, in developing my Christmas tree analogy, is 2020 going to tell the story that you are currently living? Or is 2020 going to be the start of the story you wish to tell? Your Christmas tree can be part of that untold story, should you choose to make it so. Look at your tree in all its beauty. Appreciate for what it is and draw strength from its name, its life, its spark. The meaning that you choose to give it is your meaning. Look at the lights. Perhaps they flash on not, providing a glimpse of what could be, the future that could be yours. Perhaps these lights take you to a distant place where you can dare to dream. Perhaps they can illuminate our paths, provide direction and certainty of what may be ahead. Perhaps each bowl can represent a meaningful event in our lives, something that we are thankful for, or perhaps something that we'll never get the chance to revisit. But there's a beautiful memory. Look at the ornaments and the characters that adorn your tree. What do they say to you? Why are they there? What is the story they tell? How do you give the tree personality? Just as each of you provides personality and a meaning for why we're here. These are the ornaments, the characters you place on your tree. Now I want you to look at your angel. Perhaps sitting atop your tree to enable us to see into the lives of others. Perhaps watching over everything and everyone we love. Perhaps our angel is our protector. Perhaps our angel is our refuge. Now I want you to look at the gifts that are around your tree. And I want you to think of the gift you leave others. The gifts you will take from this year of change and adaptation. The gift that you can create with and within others by just being you. The gifts are there for others to take. They are yours to give. And perhaps you may not have a tree, but this should not stop you from dreaming. A tree is but a symbol for what you choose to make of it. It's something else that you choose to be special at this time and select how you choose to embrace it. Your Christmas will be no less special because just like 2020 in COVID, we can choose not to be defined by it. Instead, I ask for you to be defined by your spirit. Then your Christmas will be truly special. Girls, please have a wonderful, happy, holy, and rewarding Christmas. I ask that you reset your goals and determine yourselves to be better for everything endured this year and probably endured much. Surround yourself with as much love as you can and create opportunity for the love of others to be drawn into your heart. Be authentic. Be authentic to your feelings and not resistant. Create your own feelings, your own stories about your family, your tree, your pets, and your loved ones. Have fun. Have fun and enjoy and know that the Holy Spirit remains within each of us. Make sensible choices. The choices are the hinges of life. Please create time to pause. Pause and reflect on what you have. And I guarantee you will see many, many riches. You will see many, many lights. You will see many, many gifts that you are just waiting to share with others. 2020 is now finished. Look forward to 2021 with renewed strength and gentleness. Merry Christmas, girls. Stay safe.
Beautiful words there, Mrs. Burke. Thank you so much for that. We now recognise those students who have achieved academically during the 2020 school year. This recognition may come in the form of an academic achievement award for excellent achievement in a particular subject, a distinguished achievement award for students who excelled in a number of subjects, or a commitment to studies award, which recognises students who are determined, consistent in their effort, consistently striving for personal excellence. This year, the awards for each year group will be read out by our pastoral care coordinators. To begin, I would like to invite Ms. Georges, our acting Year 10 pastoral care coordinator, to the stage. We can make her feel welcome, please.
My name is Ms. Georges, or Sylvia Georges, and I'm the Acting Year 10 Pastoral Care Coordinator. The Year 10 Academic Awards will be presented by our Principal, Mrs. Sharon Quirk. Please hold your applause until the names of the Year 10 Award recipients have been called. It is with great pleasure that I announce the 2020 Year 10 Awards. Nikita Agathibul, Academic Achievement in History, Commitment to Studies in English and Graphics Technology. Ginevra Aiello, Academic Achievement in Italian. Olivia Alvarez, Academic Achievement in Science, High Distinction in the Sydney Catholic Schools Religious Education Exam, achieving in the top 5% of students. Tatiana Attard, Academic Achievement, Personal Development, Health and Physical Education. Madeline Bald, Commitment to Studies in Science. Genevieve Beach, Academic Achievement in English, as well as History and Elective. Karina Bergen, Commitment to Studies in Religious Education. Annalise Troy, Commitment to Studies in History, as well as Science. Holly Clatworthy, Academic Achievement in Physical Activity and Sports Studies. Abigail Connolly, Commitment to Studies in Religious Education as well as Music. Giovanni Delegate, Academic Achievement in Religious Education. Aletta Dowd, Academic Achievement in English. Leah Doyle, Commitment to Studies in Design and Technology. Isabella England, Commitment to Studies in Science, unfortunately she's not in today. Katie Ford, commitment to studies in science. Joyful Fuchua Mala, academic achievement in history. Elizabeth Gutsis, commitment to studies in science. Zoe Gray, academic achievement in design and technology, as well as personal development and health and physical education. Alyssa Haig, academic achievement in mathematics 5.2, as well as history elective. Sophie Hammond, academic achievement in mathematics 5.2, as well as graphics technology, a commitment to studies in personal development, health and physical education. Ivory Heidegger, commitment to studies in mathematics 5.2. Kira Herford, commitment to studies in mathematics 5.2. Caitlin Hickey, academic achievement in food technology, commitment to studies in history elective. Charlie Hopp, commitment to studies in religious education, a high distinction in Sydney Catholic Schools religious education exam, achieving the top 1% of the students. Mira Jackson, academic achievement in religious education, in English, in food tech, in personal development, health and physical education, as well as a commitment to studies in history. Ava James, commitment to studies in history. Chloe Kaladirakis, commitment to studies in English. Zoe Kander, commitment to studies in English. Hannah Kent, high distinction in Sydney Catholic Schools religious education exam, achieving in the top 5% of students. Tamsin Lawrence, commitment to studies in English as well as history elective. Eliza Lee, commitment to studies in personal development, health and physical education. Cynthia Leon, academic achievement in religious education, English, mathematics 5.2, 5.3, science, visual arts, commerce, as well as a high distinction in Sydney Catholic Schools religious exam, achieving the top 5% of students. Lucia Martin Mortes, commitment to studies in Italian, commitment to studies in mathematics 5.3, 5.2, as well as physical activity and sports studies. Sophia Macy, academic achievement in religious education, commitment to studies in food technology, as well as a high distinction in the Sydney Catholic Schools religious exam, achieving in the top 1%. Daniela McHenry, commitment to studies in science. Marissa Mills, commitment to studies in science. Danielle Matoulis, academic achievement in personal development, health and physical education, a commitment to studies in mathematics 5.2, as well as food technology. Alice Norbury, commitment to studies in personal development, health and physical education. Levi Norrish, academic achievement in drama. Amelia O'Connor, commitment to studies in mathematics 5.2, as well as history. Eve Pang, academic achievement in history, commitment to studies in religious education. Emma Power, commitment to studies in design and technology. Mia Ray, academic achievement in history and commerce, commitment to studies in religious education, a high distinction in Sydney Catholic Schools religious education exam, achieving the top 2% of students. Ariella Richards, Commitment to Studies in Science. Leah Rowley, Academic Achievement in Science, a high distinction in the Sydney Catholic Schools Religious Education Exam, achieving the top 3%. Nicholas Seaman, Commitment of Students in History. Audrey Cedo, Academic Achievement in Music, high distinction in the Sydney Catholic Schools Religious Education Exam, achieving the top 3%. Unfortunately, she can't be here today. Ivana Solara, high distinction in the Sydney Catholic Schools Religious Education Exam, achieving the top 2%. Daniela Siljic, Commitment to Studies in Visual Arts. Macy Smith, Commitment to Studies in Physical Activity and Sports Studies. Ava Sabo, Commitment to Studies in Mathematics 5.3-5.2, English, as well as Personal Development, Health and Physical Education. Riri Thomas Yu, Commitment to Studies in Development, as well as Personal Development, Health and Physical Education. Eleni Trendyov-Lu, Commitment to Studies in Drama. Unfortunately, she can't make it today. Sophie Von Wheeler, Academic Achievement in Design and Technology, Personal Development, Health and Physical Education, as well as Science. Commitment to Studies in English, Commitment to Studies in Commerce, as well as a high distinction in the Sydney Catholic Schools Religious Education Exam, achieving the top 1% of students. Gabriella Wahib, high distinction in the Sydney Catholic Schools Religious Education Exam, achieving in the top 1% of students. Lola Williams, Commitment to Studies in Personal Development, Health and Physical Education. And Sylvia Zaruk, Commitment to Studies in Religious Education as well as History. I'm thankful for being your 2020 Pastoral Care. Let's give all these girls a round of applause. I would like to welcome Mr. Tony Mungia, the Year 11 Pastoral Care Coordinator, to the stage.
Good afternoon. It's with great pleasure that I announce the 2020 Year 11 Award recipients. Heidi Astridge, Commitment to Studies in Biology and Personal Development, Health and Physical Education. Idalia August, Equal First Community and Family Studies. Andrea Batista, Equal First Community and Family Studies. Charlotte Beaton, first place Modern History, Academic Achievement in English Advance, Commitment to Studies in Studies of Religion 1 and Legal Studies. Georgia Bill, Academic Achievement in English Standard. Emily Bell, first place Business Services. Veronica Berman, Academic Achievement in Modern History. Imogen Bozanov, Commitment to Studies in Mathematics Standard 2. Lola Brill, commitment to studies in English Advanced and Business Studies. Lucy Granado, commitment to studies, Business Services. Lucinda Buchanan, commitment to studies, Mathematics Standard 2. Samantha Chung, first place studies of Religion 1, commitment to studies, Business Studies. Sinead Conan, first place Design and Technology. Bridie Culligan, commitment to studies in personal development, health and physical education. Ella Cox, first place business studies, academic achievement, mathematics standard 2, and legal studies. Emma Dow, first place in ancient history. Alexandra Davidson, first place in English Standard. Kira D'Andrade, first place in Studies of Religion 2. Jasmine Deng, Academic Achievement in Mathematics Advanced. Sara De Soma, commitment to studies, hospitality. Jasmine Duff, commitment to studies and photography. The following student can be here. We would like to acknowledge Lily Fanati, commitment to studies in food technology. Saoirse Flahive, first place in biology. Ella Ford, commitment to studies in modern history. Laura Frias, equal first geography, commitment to studies in studies of religion 1. Lauren Goff, equal first geography, commitment to studies in studies of religion 1. Following student couldn't be here, but we'd like to acknowledge her, Imogen Grant, first place in English Studies. Phoebe Hode, first place in Personal Development, Health and Physical Education. Charlotte Hutchins, commitment to studies in Geography. Nicola Iliopoulos, commitment to studies in studies in Catholic thought and Italian continuous. Chloe Carpus, first place Italian continuous. Aurelia Kwan, academic achievement English standard. I'd like to acknowledge a student that's absent, Adette Leachar, commitment to studies in ceramics. Isabel Linden, commitment to studies in ancient history and modern history. Another acknowledgement of absence, Sophie Loveland, commitment to studies in English studies. Heidi McHammer, commitment to studies in design and technology. Mia Majewski, first place in studies in Catholic thought. The Patricia Miranda, commitment to studies in Mathematics Standard 2 and Hospitality. Lily McDonald, commitment to studies in Mathematics Standard 2. Charlie Milner, equal first place in drama, academic achievement in biology. Lily Miranda, first place mathematics extension 1, first place mathematics advanced, first place in physics, commitment to studies in studies of religion 1 and music. Evan Mock, academic achievement in biology and commitment to studies awards in mathematics, advanced, chemistry and economics. Larissa Masavi, commitment to studies in English advanced. Tegan Musket, academic achievement in hospitality. Joanna Nestoris, commitment to studies in biology. Georgina Engapula, commitment to studies in English standard. Rachel Musco, first place English advanced, first place chemistry. Nina Osipovic, first place photography, commitment to studies in ancient history. Serena Pelosi, equal first visual arts, first place hospitality. I'd like to acknowledge another student who couldn't be here, Natharie Kruleg, first place ceramics. Neve Rock, first place food technology, academic achievement in Mathematics Standard 2 and commitment to studies in hospitality. Eliza Sendona, commitment to studies in community and family studies. Emily Shepherd, commitment to studies in Mathematics Extension 1. Evie Louise Shooks, first place English Extension 1, first place Legal Studies, first place Visual Arts, academic achievement in English Advanced. Annalise Smart, commitment to studies in Studies of Religion 2 and Visual Arts. I'd like to acknowledge another student that couldn't be here, Lucia Spanitz, first place in Music. Vika Suresh Nair, commitment to studies in visual arts. Elizabeth Tanner, academic achievement, personal development, health and physical education, commitment to studies in mathematics advanced. Jenna Thompson, equal first place in drama. Elizabeth, you are first place Mathematics Standard 2, academic achievement in Studies of Religion 1 and Ancient History, commitment to studies in English Advanced and Legal Studies. Anna Walters, commitment to studies in Drama. Kiara Weber, commitment to studies in Music. Isabella West, commitment to studies in English Standard. Leila Yusuf, First place economics, academic achievement in studies of religion 1 and business studies, commitment to studies in English extension 1 and mathematics advanced. Rachel Jung, commitment to studies in English standard and physics. You could all give these girls a round of applause, please. I now call upon Vicky Spurs, the Director of Learning and Innovation, to present distinguished achievers.
It is my absolute honour to present the Distinguished Achiever Awards for 2020. In Year 10, our distinguished achievers have achieved A grades for all subjects studied. In 2020, our distinguished achievers are Caitlin Hickey, Mira Jackson, Cynthia Leon, please congratulate these students again. We now come to our Year 11 Distinguished Achiever Awards. Students in Year 11 study a minimum of 12 units. To be eligible for a Distinguished Achievers Award, students must achieve an A grade in 12 units or more. Our Distinguished Achievers for Year 11, 2020 are Charlotte Beaton, Samantha Chung, Lily Miranda, Rachel Nusko, Evie Louise Shooks, Elizabeth Ewer, Samantha Chung, and Layla Youssef. Congratulations to all our distinguished speakers. I'd now like to invite Ms. Sue Foxcock back to the lectern to present the special awards. Thank you, Ms. Safaris. So it's now the time in the ceremony when we present the special awards. The special awards acknowledge student contribution to diverse aspects of college life. The special awards will be presented again by our principal, Mrs. Sharon Quirk. So for contribution to college life, our first special award acknowledges students who have made a significant contribution to the college. Today, we acknowledge our choir leader, Abigail Conley. Our orchestra leader, Stavritsa Sezenis. We also acknowledge our skilled photographers, Jasmine Duff and Nina Ospovich. Please join me in congratulating these students for their significant contribution to college life. The next award is the Duke of Edinburgh Award. The Duke of Edinburgh's International Award is a leading structured youth development programme empowering all young Australians aged 14 to 24 to explore their full potential and to find their purpose, passion and place in the world, regardless of their location or circumstance. Participants are required to complete four sections: voluntary service, skill, physical recreation, and adventurous journey. In 2020, the recipient of the Duke of Edinburgh Bronze Award is Sinead Connan. The next award is the Philippa MacDonald Award, and this is an award for writing. The Philippa MacDonald Award is presented to students at this college who have achieved excellence in their communication of ideas related to a social justice theme. Philippa MacDonald is an ex-student of Brigidine College whose career as an ABC journalist has spanned 30 years. She's emblematic of the Women of Strength, Gentleness and Ethical Commitment to leave this school and contribute to the betterment of the larger world. Philippa MacDonald has not only been careful and courageous in her journalistic investigations, she's always conveyed her compassion for the people she's met in the course of her reporting. This year, the Year 11 student being awarded with a Philippa MacDonald Cup is Evie Louise Shook.
Eva's artwork, in her own words, focuses on enduring issues of objectification and commodification prevalent to the female experience. That is, her painting, I'm a Little Teapot, challenges the strong cultural association between women and the domestic role. As we know, and as Evie knows, Brigidine girls can do anything. Congratulations to Evie. Well done. The next award, the Australian Nuclear Science and Technology Organisation Science Medals. These are given out to celebrate and encourage success in science, technology, engineering and mathematics subjects, STEM. The recipients of the 2020 Australian Nuclear Science and Technology Organisation Science Award is Olivia Alvarez. Well done, Olivia. Our next award is the Australian Defence Force Long Tan Award. This recognises a Year 10 student who has demonstrated leadership and teamwork within both the school and the broader community. This student works collaboratively with other students and is accepting of others' views which may differ from her own. Her work ethic and determination to challenge herself are exemplary. Nothing is ever too difficult or ever too inconvenient. This student is cooperative and engages with others in a healthy manner. She is maintaining respectful and mature relationships with her peers. She is community-minded, shows initiative, she's empathetic, respected by her peers, and has positive relationships with all of those around her. This year, the Long Tan Award is presented to Cynthia Leong. Congratulations, Cynthia. Award is the Australian Defence Force Innovators Award. The Australian Defence Force is encouraging the next generation of innovators, critical thinkers and problem solvers, bright Australian students who are succeeding in STEM, science, technology, engineering and maths. This award is presented to a student in Year 10 who has the ability to demonstrate innovation and learning in the fields of science, technology, engineering and maths. This award is a means to formally recognise a student who has demonstrated motivation and innovation in the areas of STEM within the college and who displays strong personal ethical values such as doing one's best. This year's recipients of the Australian Defence Force Innovator Award is Sophie Bombala. Well done, Sophie. Our next award is the Reuben F. Scarf Award for Commitment. The Reuben F. Scarf Award for Commitment recognises and honours consistent effort and the desire to improve. This award aims at building students' confidence to help them along the path of success. The recipient of this award is consistent in her efforts and application. She engages readily in her classwork and is highly motivated to meet new challenges and achieve her best at all times. Her attitude to academic life has earned her the respect of all the teachers at the college. In recognition of this 2020 recipient, This award goes to Lola Brill. Congratulations, Lola. The Caltech Best Soul Rounder Award is our next award. This recognises students for their leadership qualities and commitments across a range of activities. Throughout her time at Bridgetine College, this student excels in an array of activities. She achieves scholastically across a range of subjects. She is willing to help others before herself. She's a role model for the students. She actively and enthusiastically participates in school and community activities. She is a great ambassador for this college. This student is commended for her outstanding contribution, not only to the Bridgetine College, but to the wider community. The Caltech Best All-Rounder Award for 2020 goes to Charlotte Milner. An outstanding achievement. Well done, Charlotte. The next award is the Sydney University Academic Award. The Sydney University Academic Award is presented to a student who has shown academic excellence throughout her time in the junior school. The recipient of this award is a curious and determined learner. She gives every effort to her studies, collaborates with her teachers, and is always ready to assist her peers. The Sydney University Academic Excellence Award for 2020 goes to Cynthia Leon. Well done, Cynthia. The next award is Dr. Marjorie O'Neill, member which is Social Impact Award. This award is presented to a student who has shown outstanding commitment to their classmates, their school, and their community. This student has displayed an understanding and appreciation of civic responsibility, has proven themselves to possess great strength of character, and the courage to do what is right. This award looks to celebrate and promote bold citizenship within the school and the wider community. This year, the award is presented to Abigail Connolly. Well done. The next award is the Kingsford Smith Community Award. The award recipient today is a student who demonstrated strong leadership and teamwork skills in the college community. She is always positive, engaging, and always engages with her learning. She's known for being a proactive member of the community. The Kingsford Smith Service recipient is always giving of herself without expecting recognition. She's a student who is positive and respectful of others, displaying genuine care for those in our community. The student is highly respected by her peers and staff. Her cheerful, cooperative, responsible, and capable nature is an asset, and she is highly deserving of this award. The 2020 recipient at the Kingsford Smith Service Award is Mira Jackson. going to watch a short video, Matt Thistle's Wait, MP for Kingsford Smith, has left a little announcement that he wanted to share. So here's just a very short clip.
G'day, Bridgetine College. I'm sorry I can't be there with you for your end of year presentation day. I'm in Canberra for our final week of Parliament. Congratulations to Mayra Jackson on being awarded the Kingsford Smith Community Service Award for 2020. Mayra, you've shown great leadership and representation of the school's values of compassion and caring for others in our community. You set a fine example for the student body and others in our community. Well done, Mayra. I hope everyone has a very happy and safe Christmas, and I look forward to working with you in 2021.
Great job, welcome, Mayra. The next award is St. Bridget's Fire. The St. Bridget's Fire Award acknowledges Year 11 students who've been nominated for the commitment to and promotion of social justice, and who on a daily basis lives out all that St. Bridget stood for: hospitality, compassion, courage, justice, wisdom. The nominees of this award are Juanita Bailey. Alina Balinski-Myfet. Imogen Grant. Odette Wachia. And Charlotte Milner. Oh, Lena's here. Yes, she's coming up. Well done to all the recipients for the St. Bridget's Fire Award. St. Bridget's Cup. St. Bridget's Cup is given to a student who embodies the essence of the spirit of St. Bridget of Bridgetine College through her commitment to and promotion of social justice. The recipient of the St. Bridget's Cup is a student of quiet strength and poise, and she carries into everything she does. She's kind, compassionate, and caring. The student always puts others first. She demonstrates qualities of inclusivity, generosity, and service, and is prominent in worthwhile college and community projects. This student is very humble and very much respected by her peers and the staff. The winner of the St. Bridget's Cup in 2020 is Alina Balinski-Myfet. Need a big cabinet arena. The Student of the Year Awards will be announced by the College Director of Pastoral Care, Mrs. Natasha Fox. I invite Ms. Fox up to the lectern. Could you make her feel very welcome, please? The Student of the Year is a student who has demonstrated strong religious commitment, leadership skills, strive to achieve her best in her studies, earned the respect of her peers and college staff, demonstrated qualities of inclusivity and generosity, and has a positive attitude and sense of pride in college. I would like to welcome back to the stage our Year 10 Pastoral Care Coordinator, Ms. Georges, who will present the Year 10 Award.
2020 Year 10 Student of the Year has demonstrated great leadership skills and sincere dedication to everything she encounters. She strives to do well in her studies by pursuing excellence. This student continues to set high standards for herself, not only in her application to her studies, but in maintaining her integrity and connectedness to the broader community. She has embraced all that Bridgedine has offered, supporting various charities and projects, and giving up her time without question. She has a positive attitude towards peers, teachers, and whatever is asked of her. She is responsible, respectful, and is profoundly proud and appreciative of the opportunities she has been afforded at the college. It is with great pride that I announce that the 2020 Student of the Year for Year 10 is Lucia. Ask Ms. Mangia, our Year 11 Master Care Coordinator, to join and support the stage. The Year 11 Student of the Year is a deserving recipient of the award. She is a student who emulates a warmth of spirit through her interactions with both peers and college staff. She is a natural leader who leads not by taking the spotlight, but rather through her qualities of humility and generosity, and through her determination to always put others before herself. Beyond this, she participates in all areas of college life, perhaps most outstandingly in her contribution to the cultural life of the college through her sporting achievements. She has earned the sincere respect of her teachers and peers. It is right and fitting that she concludes this year by being acknowledged with this award. The 2020 Year 11 Student of the Year is Heidi Astor. Thank you, Ms. Fox. We now come to our final award, and that is of the Year 11 Ducks. This student has excelled in all subjects studied, and this is the school's most prestigious award. The Ducks of Year 11, 2020, goes to Lily Miranda. Congratulations, Lily. You've been incredibly proud of yourself. Watching students grow, develop, and accomplish their goals is one of the main reasons people choose to pursue careers in education. For the staff who have invested in the award recipients, these awards signify a job well done.
Likewise, the family and friends who have cared for and encouraged these students can view their accomplishments with a sense of pride. After all, the guidance provided by these support systems has helped make their achievements possible. As we wrap up this whirlwind academic year and continue to navigate the challenges associated with COVID-19, it's easy to get caught up in our busy schedules and planning for the future. I am grateful that this year's Academic and Special Achievement Awards allow us to reflect on all that has been accomplished. We definitely have a lot to celebrate. On behalf of the entire Brigidine College community, I would like to wish you all a happy and holy Christmas. Goodbye to our friends and family online. Thank you for joining us. Please could students remain seated until instructed otherwise by your pastoral care coordinators. Can we give everybody a big round of applause?